persevere. There ain't no situation that you ever had to respond to that's adverse. Messiest thing you've ever gone through is your purse. Yeah, I don't cry like hell, but I might as well hang it up like a shelf. Gotta keep rolling with it, evolve.
What up, my honor? Welcome back to another video. And today, I'm reacting to Encore Top 10 Massacre in Anime. Dang. So, Massacre, like, is a lot of chaos, huh? So, if y'all check my, like, when I react to the top 10, Jujutsu Kaisen, which was lit, but I was gonna react towards, their fights, scenes. So, right now, I'm gonna check out the Massacre in anime. Like, people be doing some crazy stuff happening. So, I'm not gonna have no time to talk about it. Before I do start this video, please y'all go ahead and hit that subscribe button if y'all new. And what's up? Oh, I forget about the season 3. The Beast Titan was throwing freaking rocks like it was childish.
But before we start, we need to clarify that the ranking's not about how good the anime is, since there are lots of other factors like numbers, presentation, and the everlasting effect on the story and characters. So don't get shocked if we start off with your favorite show.
What the heck? Is that a bunch of bunnies?
However, you're free to comment on how the list should have been ranked. And also, don't worry if your favorite anime genocide didn't make the list, because if this video does well, we're planning to make volume 2 of this topic. So without further ado, let's start. Number 10, Battle of Alnus Hill. Sticks and stones sure break my bones, but AK-47 is the soul. What better way to start off a list like this more than showcasing the advancements of modern-day warfare? After the events of the gate opening in modern-day Japan Episode 1, the Japanese Self-Defense Forces, JSDF, gets deployed on the other side of the gate to find out and arrest the person who orchestrated the attack on the Japanese civilians. However, as soon as they landed on the other side, the JSDF were faced by clear aggression in the form of orcs, goblins, spears, and swords.
Dang, a matter of time to show that it was a very wise move on the behalf of the Imperial. Oh man, man. Damn, how wrong did they get their money?
Army, because as soon as the Imperial Army began the death march towards the JSDF,
even a flying all year day in a war, I'm a god.
Conversely,
that's true.
That in a fight between a dragon and an Apache helicopter, the Apache always wins.
I forget about this. The season 3.
Beast Titan Massacre. Foul ball.
Foul ball.
Getting into the basement, Beast Titan attacks.
Bro, he just crushed the rocks and just throws at him like it was nothing.
Beast Titan flexed his pitching game by throwing a handful of rocks, destroying entire blocks of neighborhoods with each throw. To put the massacre size into perspective,
Beast Titan, look at the blood, bro. That is crazy. He just did that like it was nothing.
Red from the amount of blood vapor in it. Not to mention the soldiers who were killed on the suicide attack as well, in order to give Levi some time, which proves once again, nothing good happens when you go to the basement. Number 8, the Shinjuku Massacre. Bang, bang. Teenager making guns with his fingers would be more dangerous than a dumb teenager with an AK-47. After broadcasting...
He's just doing the bang, bang, and people been dying?
Made it as clear as a newly...
Yo!
Could be ...that he hates Japan, and that he perceives every single soul in it as his enemy. As such, he begins shooting with his robotic finger, killing people left and right, till the death toll hits 100, and before that, he murdered a total of 85 people...
85 people.
Team members. That guy sure doesn't have any tolerance towards those horrible, horrible CGI crowds.
That's Naruto. I definitely was sure about that.
For this pick, we could have easily gone with Madara versus the World, but we went with the Uchiha clan massacre as it had an emotional toll. Here's some background on the reason.
I remember that one. Clan leader Fugaku, that definitely right there, that he killed the entire clan.
Switch things up, plotting a coup against the leadership of Konoha.
That makes everyone. That's meant the Naruto fans hate a lot of people.
Strongest young member with a nearly impossible choice. wipe out his own clan for the good of Konoha or die with them. Itachi agreed to carry out the massacre because he was first very loyal to Konoha Village, and secondly because he wanted to protect his emo edgelord little brother Sasuke. In that two-man crusade, Itachi and Tobi wiped the whole clan out in one fell swoop. The only good thing that came out from the massacre was not Sasuke.
That was horrifying.
It was all these sick wallpapers.
Kind of overlord.
Too little demon sheep. What other suitable way could you, as a supreme being, showcase?
Wait, what happened?
Other than killing thousands of people. For me, I would have asserted dominance by watching off-brand anime in public, because nothing really shouts supreme being other than turning the volume up for that sweet Yamete Kudasai drop. But for Sorcerer Supreme, Ayn's all gone, asserting dominance came in the form of five black baby demon goats, with each having
baby goats
holes fused together, forming one big, wobbly, ugly-ass goat running down the enemy soldiers.
Ayn-sama!
In fifth place,
what the heck is that?
Massacre. Blender goes brrrr.
Oh!
Holy sweet mother of Jesus! How can one come up with the words to describe this massacre? This attacks one's brain. Watching the clip of this genocide, you wouldn't feel anything but uncomfortable.
He just put it in
the reason why this pick is higher than Attack on Titan, and it's called Human Barbecue Party. From snatching people from their warm beds to putting dozens in a bag and killing them as if they were cracked eggs in a blender, this show is certainly no easy ride for the weak stomach individual. The person who came up with this piece of art needs either some psychotherapy or Jesus in their life. Because
for real, this is horrifying.
You know what? I can't continue. I want to stay monetized because, frankly, I like to eat.
What she said?
And number four, the Special Administrative Zone Massacre. Crank gone wrong. Kids, if you have a special power that can let you control other people and let them do whatever you wish, you've got to be careful when you fool around, because when you joke and it bombs, it fucking bombs. But don't take it from me, take it from Uncle Lelouch, who decided to be the funny man while discussing privately with Euphemia about Japan's future. As he was talking to her, Lelouch suddenly loses control of his gias while jokingly telling her to kill all the Japanese. Not being able to stop her there and then leads to lots of innocent people dying.
Oh snap, she crazy.
Or kick the bucket. Yes, there goes Lelouch's stand-up career. It was one joke lived. In third place, the London Massacre. Carnage in the air. Everybody's a Nazi until Alucard releases Level Zero. In what could be considered the ultimate flex move, Alucard releases his true power after the Nazis, KKK clansmen, and church creeps think they've cornered him. Alucard pulls the ultimate FU move by devouring a portion of the enemy lines and turning them into mindless soldiers under his control, just like the ones who were foolish enough to stand against him throughout history. Alucard releases them, waves above waves of tortured souls.
That's crazy.
Streams to rivers of blood. By far, this is my favorite pick on this list, just because of the sheer badassery that came from that episode. The whole sequence was like a portrait. Every frame could be a wallpaper.
Bro, what the... Oh yeah, I do watch Hellsing. I mean, it was a good show.
Second place, The Eclipse. You are entering a world of pain. Now you think Attack on Titan Eren seeing his mom killed was dark. You think Goblin Slayer's nameless sister getting raped by little goblins was dark. You think the Bunny Massacre was as worse as it gets? Then why not try watching Berserk? This timeless classic will make you reconsider. Berserk's last episode, The Eclipse, was all the above-mentioned 10 times over. Guts' companions were all killed in the most gruesome and painful fashion. His lover was raped in front of him by his friend, formerly, I had to point it out, not to mention
the homie's arm.
He had to endure to cut off his arm in order to stop it. And what made that scene even worse is the fact that Griffith didn't move whatsoever, locking his sight on Guts while defiling poor Casca's soul and body. I have nothing but mad respect to Guts for staying strong instead of breaking beyond Reaper.
Oh, the DBZ saga. Definitely remember that. Frieza, man.
Number one, Frieza destroys planet Vegeta. Fireworks. Fearing the imminent threat of a legendary warrior being born, King Frieza destroys a whole planet for being insecure, kicking off the events of the whole Dragon Ball universe. Now, some of you won't like this as the number one pick, and before you dislike the video, just listen, hear me out, okay? We chose the Uchiha clan massacre instead of Madara killing people because how it affected the main character's personality, okay? We picked Beast Titan's killing spree for the death toll that came from that episode, so it's only natural to put the destruction of planet Vegeta at number one because it combined both.
Yeah, I can't blame him. That's true. He did destroy the entire planet.
Characters and the story. The destruction of King Vegeta's planet became a part of the culture, and not knowing about it is just downright blasphemy.
I just do not like Freezer, man. The way how he did that was so messed up.
Right, we hope you enjoyed the list. We tried to stay away as much as possible from planet destruction picks, because if we included too much of those, the whole list would basically just be all Dragon Ball. As said earlier at the start of the video, Volume 2 is under consideration, so if you enjoyed this one, let us know by liking, sharing, and commenting, as well as, of course, by subscribing. It would give us a boost of motivation to continue. Until next time.
You know what? I definitely agree with them. He put number one for Frieza destroying planet Vegeta, because he did destroy planet Vegeta with thousands of Saiyans in that planet. But dang, these massacres insane. But that's a good video by Ancora, man. Shout out to you, man. Alright, man. About to head on out. I hope y'all like this video. Y'all go ahead. We're gonna play now, ready for the show.